Hey guys, this is Austin, and today I'm here with a full tutorial on how to build a gaming computer. With the current generation of consoles stuck in 2006, there's never been a better time to build yourself a gaming PC. To start with, let me go over the parts, which are all from my latest $500 budget gaming build. If you're building that computer, then perfect, but even if you're building a different machine, this tutorial still applies. I won't go into detail on each part, so if you want to know more, feel free to check out that video and then come back here when you're done. To build the computer, you should have a decently sized workspace, and as far as tools go, all you really need is a Phillips screwdriver and a knife. You should also work on tile or hardwood floors, as if you build on carpet, you could potentially build up some static electricity, which could harm your components. It's also a good idea to touch the steel case before handling any sensitive parts to ground yourself out. The first step is grabbing our case, which for this build is an Antec 300. Bust out the unboxing knife and pop the cap on the box. You'll find a bit of foam, and under that the instructions, which of course we aren't going to look at. We're rebels like that. Flip the box upside down, and then pull the box over the case. Then just pull the plastic wrap off and flip it right side up. Now that we've freed the case, it's a good idea to look it over to check if it was damaged in shipping. If everything's good, move around to the back and undo the four thumb screws holding the side panels on. Slide both the left and right panels off so we have room to work. Inside you should find a small box of accessories, which will contain two small bags of screws. Put these aside as we'll be needing them a bit later. Push the case off to the side for a bit and grab your power supply. Inside here is another manual, the power cable, a few small screws, and the supply itself. Grab it and remove the plastic wrap. Now let's install it. Make sure it's oriented correctly with the cables coming out the back, and then place it on the bottom of your case. There should be metal tabs to make sure you've got it properly aligned, but the best way to check is to look at the rear of the case. There are four screw holes you'll need to keep the supply in place. Double check that all of these are lined up. If not, readjust the supply until it's all good. Grab the small bag of screws you get with the power supply and your screwdriver. Drop a screw into one of the holes and tighten it decently but not all the way in case something needs to be readjusted. Then go to the hole opposite where the first screw is and do that one. Then just finish the last two screws. Now that everything is in the proper place, go back and tighten each screw down to make sure the supply isn't going anywhere. Nicely done, we have the first component in our build installed. Push the case back for a bit and grab your motherboard. In here you should find a pair of SATA cables, one straight and one angled, and the I/O shield for your ports. Set the motherboard aside for a second, and below you'll find the manual and driver's DVD. Set this one aside, as it actually is helpful later on. Now, gently pull the motherboard out and set it on the bag. One thing to keep in mind is that the motherboard is one of the most sensitive parts to static, so when you are handling it, always touch it by the plastic parts. You should also leave it on the anti-static bag instead of letting it sit on your table. Before we move on, let's take a look at a few of the important features of the board. First of all is the CPU socket, which as the name implies is where your CPU goes. To the right of this are the slots where you'll install RAM. Below the CPU socket, you should see your PCI Express slots. These are what you'll plug your graphics card into, as well as various other cards like Wi-Fi or capture cards. Toward the bottom of the board are four SATA connectors, which are for connecting hard drives. On some motherboards, you'll have two types, SATA 2 and SATA 3. The only difference is that SATA 3 is faster and works better if you have an SSD. There are more important bits on the board, but those are the main things you need to learn. Now grab your processor. If you're using an Intel CPU like we are, the process is identical, but AMD CPUs install slightly differently. Bust the box open, and inside you'll find the manual along with the Core i3 sticker, stock heatsink and fan, along with the CPU, which is a little too easy to overlook. Like the motherboard, this is an extremely delicate part, so only touch it by the edges when handling it. To install, you'll need to push back the arm holding the socket closed and lift the protective cover off. Now line up the two small notches on the CPU to the notches in the socket and gently rest it down. Do not apply any pressure at all, it should rest nicely by itself. Lie the cover back down and firmly press the arm down under the clip. It will give a lot of resistance, but don't worry, just press it all the way down until it's secure. Now you've got one of the hardest parts of the build taken care of. Moving on, we have to install the heatsink. For this build, I'll be using the stock Intel cooler, however if you're using an aftermarket cooler, then it's best to look up a specific tutorial, as they all install differently. The stock cooler is easy, on the bottom you'll find thermal paste already applied. All you need to do is align it over the CPU, with each of the four pegs inside the holes on the motherboard. Then press each down by starting on the opposite corners until they click into place. Once it's installed, you can lift the motherboard by the heatsink. Slide the motherboard off to the side and grab your RAM. For this build, we'll be using a pair of 2GB DIMMs, which will give the build 4GB. These aren't extremely delicate, however it's still a good idea to only handle them by the heatsink or edges. On the bottom, you'll find a series of gold pins with a slightly offset notch. You'll see a matching notch in the slot on the motherboard, which means they can only go in one way. Pop open the clips on the side, and then drop the RAM in. Press firmly on both ends until it snaps into place. Then just pop the other DIMM in the same way and you're good to go. That's it for part 1 of this tutorial. If you enjoyed, definitely be sure to leave this video a thumbs up, and check out part 2, which will be on screen now as well as in a link in the description of this video.